In 12 months, NSSF has improved collections from a previous 700 billion shillings to 1 trillion shillings last financial year. This was despite a tough year, which will also ascertain that savers will get a decent interest rate. According to the NSSF Managing Director Richard Byarugaba, less than expected performance in Uganda's best investments was shored up by investments elsewhere in Kenya and Tanzania and helped generate a decent return. The fair performance in the investments in the rest of the region sets a way forward which will not necessarily favor Uganda.
I would love to invest in Uganda, but there is no infrastructure bonds here, right? As a structure, right? There, you know, we've not done the things that the other countries have done, right? Which is very, very specific. They want this investment. They're calling for it. And that's it. If you look at our stock exchange market, when was the last time we listed any company, right? It is, I can tell you, it is Umeme, 2011 or 2012.
However, the solution for Uganda still lies in NSSF, especially in providing long-term funds that are now easily developing other economies of East Africa.
Remove those shackles that we've been able to even work with, but remove those shackles so that we can work a little bit, we can do a little bit faster for our members, because our members are onto a very good thing.
The fund will also grow investment in equity or buying shares in already existing companies, especially in the areas of cement, manufacture and hotel business. Ingrid Nantege, NTV Business.